All right, let's see what we got. Destruction ray.
Crap.
Eye of the Gorgon.
Crapola.
Pre-owned energy ball.
Used crap.
Shrink ray. Hey, shrink ray.
Shrink rays are for rejects. I need a weapon that's as stylish yet deadly. And single.
And stupid. What'd you do with the shopping list, anyway?
She quit peeking around and get the Waz himself. He's the man.
The man. Hey, Steve.
Waz.
It's me, Moltar. I am not a peeacker.
R2.
Am not.
R2.
Am not.
R2.
Am not.
Yeah, you are.
Am not.
R2.
Am not.
R2.
I know you are, but what am I?
Peeacker.
What's this? Ball peen hammer for Space Ghost's head. Steel spike for Space Ghost's head. Hey!
Guest in the hole!
Who's this hump?
Oh, him? He's the man.
The man? Never heard of him. Who are you?
Okay, my name is Steve Wozniak.
And he deals in pain.
What?
He said that he plays on the Chinese national ping pong team.
Ping pong, eh?
There's a lot of them.
Manly. I was quite the paddler in my day. So what brand of ping pong do you like? A nice match of shirts versus skins?
It's a real rough, high-paced faction game, and there's your hands have to play it faster than your brain cannon.
Brain cannon?
Brain cannon? Is it stylish yet deadly?
Again with the arms dealers? These turds are always up to something, Steve. You gotta keep an eye on them.
Hey, tell me about the brain cannon.
This is like the greatest technology ever.
Stop right there. The Space Ghost Spank Ray is the greatest technology ever. Patent pending. So, Steve, you feel good about playing table tennis for the commies, do you? I hear their groupies are smoking hot.
Boy, you know, there are probably people that have a lot of good stories for you, and I just don't.
Love it or leave it, Chairman Steve. Love it or leave it.
Jeez, he's a game pioneer. Ask him about games.
Games, eh? Did you make Mantastic? An Adventure in Time?
Breakout, it was called.
Breakout. Sick monkeys.
What? What?
Breakout. That was the Sick Monkey movie. The one where the monkey gets sick who was it? Al Pacino had to rush in by helicopter and save the community with like a magic serum. No? Oh. No, never mind. Let's get back on track, shall we, Steve? Breakout. What about it?
We had to design Breakout in 4 days and nights, and a game would normally take 6 man months, you know, or many man months.
Man months?
Yeah.
Man months. Manuary. Testus July.
All right, Waz. Hand it over.
Mustache of Ember.
Brain cannon, brain cannon, brain cannon. Brain cannon, brain cannon, brain cannon.
He's not
going
to shut up till you give him one.
Bring it.
Sure.
By September.
Dismember, Simber. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Wozniak, I step away for a few man months, and you sell a thermoneural weapon to a crazed mantis with a lust for blood?
I just like doing that for fun.
Yacker.
Not all of-
Sir, I've been a fan of yours since the Blizzard of 96. No, stupid. What's the matter with me?
This calls for gravitas. Okay. All right, I'm ready.
Sir, as a broadcasting colleague, I'm honored to work in the same industry as a man of your stature.
Bryant Gumble tried to break you, and he failed.
Oh, yeah. That's the sweet stuff.
Good. Good. Mm-hmm.
So, did Katie's colonoscopy really weird you out, too?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the most beloved TV personality in the known universe. A Renaissance man for the ages, voice of a generation, and the first Ronald McDonald, Willard Scott. Moltar, where's Willard?
It's Howard Scott Warshaw. Should read the card next time, genius.
Howard Scott Warshaw? Look, it says right here, look, I'm going to show it to you. It says right here in plain English, something ard Scott something.
I can't tell you how exciting it is for me to be here on the screen.
Oh, shut up, you. You're not the great man who immortalized my Aunt Mabel on a jelly jar.
Well, it's great to be here, SG. Looking forward to this for quite a while.
Get me my Willard. Willard! I can't tell you how happy...
There he is.
I am... Did you... I mean...
There he isn't.
You're here!
There he is.
On the...
Now he's gone.
On the show. No whammies. No whammies. No whammies. No whammies. No whammies. No whammies. Now! Yes! Ah!
Aw, too bad.
Apparently my guest today is Howard Scott Warshaw.
I still have to say that it is an honor to be here and share this with you, and I can't thank you enough for giving me this opportunity to relive some of the most important things for me. You know, just thank you very much.
Yeah, splendid. Whatever.
My Little Pony collector, bocce ball enthusiast, entomologist specializing in yars.
What the heck are yars?
Well, yars are very interesting little creatures.
And yars a kind of bug, right? You know, Zorak's a bug.
Insect.
Why don't you and Zorak finish this thing up?
Bug is the oppressive language of a bourgeois scientific community who have sought to oppress my genus and assert their false superiority since the beginning of time. I, sir, am an insect.
So, back to the bugs.
Insects! You and your ignorance will rue the day!
Careful, Sparky. Daddy's got 4,000 watts of fast-acting, long-lasting, long-range electrical discharge right here on the bug zapper ray. So, Warshaw,
stuff that up your...
why are these yars so interesting?
On some of the first interplanetary journeys that people took from Earth, a few flies got to work their way into the hole. And through all
yar.
The radiation that goes on, they were traveling
yars,
and they were probably near...
Where do I know that name from?
So they started to...
Yar!
Mutate
yar! Yar Krikorian!
Did someone call my name?
Bug on the set! Bug on the set!
Insect.
Oh.
Zorak, my old nemesis.
Yar. Yar Krikorian.
What's it been? 20 years?
Tja, not long enough.
20 years since you stole her away from me.
I didn't steal her. She left you, Yar. She was all woman. And she was all mine!
Nah, I don't care.
She was beauty personified. She had hands and a face. Mandibles of a goddess. And every time she sneezed, a baby bird was born. She was a magical being. And you never appreciated her, Yar. That's why she left you.
That's why it's payback time.
Come on, give him a good old fist beating, frontier style.
You know, if I had a button to show you the tingles...
What?
Fight!
It's go time!
Bring it!
Hit him! I got your backyard. Go ahead.
Can it, Ghost? Willard Scott told me he hates you.
Liar! Oh. Come on, Yar. You okay, buddy? Come on, get up. Shake it off.
Yeah, get up!
Tell Lenore she was a bad kisser.
You should check his lineage.
Oh, I'm not touching him there.
So, Yar, we're amigos, am I right? Compadres? Hermanos?
Si.
Then I can trust you with the secret, right?
Of course. To trust is manly.
Well, all right. It's like this. I keep having the same nightmare.
This is not manly.
You think I don't know that?
My manliness is everything. I'm all about the manly. I'm Butch McMacho.
Forgive me. Go on.
There's this faceless guy with a hatchet. Every time I close my eyes, he's there. I had to change my sheets for the third night in a row. That's not me.
Attention, Ghost Planet shoppers. Space Ghost Pete is dead.
Shameful.
I did not. It was night sweats.
Most unmanly. I despise you.
But we're amigos. Hermanos.
I spit on your shoes.
Yar.
Space Ghost Pete is dead.
No, I didn't.
Look at him. He's probably peeing now.
Allow me to put you out of your misery, woman man.
I'll get back to you on that.
Greetings, citizens. Before we begin, I'd like to make the following special announcement. I am in complete control of my bladder. Now, Bug, play me to the desk.
Wait! I have an announcement. Moltar, why did the lava chicken cross the road?
I don't know.
'Cause Space Ghost Pete is bad.
Hey, Space Ghost, look out behind you. It's the Hatchet Man.
Nice try. Just bring in the guest.
Keep your pants on.
Just don't pee him.
Creepy-looking individual. Identify yourself.
Steven, with a PH preferably. I'll take anything. Bristow, B-R-I-S-T-O-W.
That's correct. So, Steven, with a PH, tell us where you're from.
Atari and other places of origin.
So, you invented the joystick?
We didn't invent the concept of a joystick. We just made a cheap, reliable one.
Think you could make me some cheap, reliable sidekicks? Ah, because these two are really sucky.
Sheesh, tough room.
So, cheap joysticks, huh? You must have been raking it in.
We were collecting, like, you know, over $1,000 in quarters, which is a bunch of bags.
Of?
Rusty can openers to kill Space Ghost with.
Flesh-eating magma bombs to kill Space Ghost with.
New sidekicks?
Of quarters.
Hey, you're good at this.
Turn, I was gonna guess quarters.
You did occasionally have the image of me walking down carrying the quarters and my hatchet.
Hatchet?
Am I awake? Is Steven with a PH?
Moltar, lose this guy's face, stat!
What's a face stat?
Just get rid of his face!
Okay.
Free copy of... No! Leave the rest of him, just lose his face! Egad! It's him! It's...
The Hatchet Man!
Hey, Ted! Need a diaper?
Can it, Bug? So, Steven...
Taking syzygy.
Oh, gesundheit. Need a hanky?
The guy who had it didn't want to share access.
Huh? This guy isn't so scary after all.
I know Cynthia, the pseudo-computer, but I don't know Joy.
I mean, he doesn't even make sense.
Boy, the mind goes.
I'll say. So, Steve-o,
What's it gonna take for you to let me sleep in peace?
I can't give you the magic answer on how you come up with something.
How about a job here on the ghost planet? Long hours, no pay, regularly scheduled meetings for Zorak? It was one of Yar's ideas, something he picked up in the Guatemalan prison.
You know, I could be chief engineer or grand poobah.
We already have a grand poobah. Me. Anything else?
Large bags of cash.
Right, like that's gonna happen.
I won't say no to a good meal.
Let's ask the judges. Tacos for everyone. Fiesta!
Then there was this one time, get this, I was having drinks with a lava chicken.
Oh, shut up!
You're just mad because you don't have a story.
No. A story is usually something with, I don't know, a point. Right, Moltar? Wait a minute, where's Moltar?
On vacation?
I allow vacations?
Sure.
Since when?
Since, that time, you know, when we had that guest on, the vacation lady.
Oh, right. The vacation lady. What a knockout. Oof. Reminded me of Maude Adams in Octopussy.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, nice chatting with you.
Huh?
Hey, well, I gotta go. It's time for my vacation, too.
Not so fast, Bug.
Ow!
What have you done with Moltar?
Nothing. What do you care anyway? You hate Moltar.
Do I, Zorak? Do I?
Yes. Ow! Was that really necessary?
No. Hang on, Moltar. Daddy's coming to save ya.
Welcome to Zorak Coast to Coast. Tell me your name, human flea, before I melt your eyes and use them for shoeshine.
David Crane.
Lucky guess. What's your occupation, meatbag?
Co-founder of Activision and currently chief technical officer of Skyworks Technologies.
You look like you work at a Radio Shack. Die, stock boy! You wouldn't happen to have a couple of 9 volts on you.
I can't help you out there.
As I searched for Moltar, Zorak's words echoed in my mind.
What do you care anyway? You hate Moltar!
And he's right. I do hate Moltar. But I have spent a lot of years with that backstabbing mutant, making the finest late-night talk show in basic cable history. Could it be that time has made me hate him less? Why? Why? Why?
Listen up, Crane. I'm taking over this joint, and you're gonna help me do it. I got 10 legions of Mantis men ready to seize control of the planet and stand on Space Ghost Head while I chew his fingers off. What do you got?
We have Space Invaders, we have Missile Command, we have...
Who's the we? Are you psychotic?
Any one of which could get you to your planet.
It is my planet. Mine, mine, mine! Bow before the mighty Zorak! Kneel! Kneel! Kneel, 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 kneel! Kneel!
I feel so empty. Why? Why?
This is terrible. How can you go on making the finest late-night talk show in basic cable history without Moltar, your trusty technical director and comedic foil?
I don't know.
Get your head together, son. Moltar is your sworn enemy. Sure, it's fun filling his helmet with lighter fluid and making him dodge Roman candles, but he's always trying to kill you and mess up your show. If anything, you hate him more.
You're right, me. I do hate Moltar more. When I find him, I'm gonna kick his ass. You guys good with that?
Great plan.
We good.
Love it.
Yep. So, you check around the studio before you went flying off into space, genius?
Shut up, me.
Anybody pack a lunch?
Okay, then it's a deal. I get to keep everything. Everything is mine. And I rule with an iron fist. And if you're lucky, I'll toss you a cheeseburger for your troubles, fatty.
Sure, cheeseburgers be fine.
You're a compliant little minion. Maybe someday I'll let you rule the dark side of the ghost planet.
Well, in the dark, I suppose you don't need pants.
Moltar! You fiend! I've been scouring the outer reaches of the Ghost Nebula looking for your sorry butt all day.
What? I was on the can.
Oh, yeah, likely story.
Who died and made you the potty police?
That does it.
Oh, it's on.
Go for the windpipe.
And to think, I thought, I hated you less.
I can't believe you went. Look it for me. I didn't want to tear your lungs out and stomp on them. I'd be touched.
No. It's completely out of character for me to care. Even a whit about you. I feel so manipulated. Zorak.
Uh-oh.
Like you didn't see that coming.
Greetings, citizens. SG in the His House, bearing the gift of entertainment. Now, let's give a great big ghost planet hey-hey to our very special guest, the lovely Chantal Clarette.
Hello, Space Ghost. I love you a lot.
Why, thank you. I love me, too.
Oh, man. I just puked in my helmet.
Oh, I'm Space Ghost. Look at me. I'm so handsome. Watch me flex. Love me. Look at me. Love me. Kiss me. Kiss me all over.
Unlock the bathroom. It's running down my legs.
Look at my ripping stomach.
Why is the bathroom door locked again?
A big one right on my butt.
I see here, Chantal, that you're the lead singer of a...
I need the bathroom key right now.
...of a peppy teen rock group called...
I need the bathroom key.
I can't say this on the air.
Come on.
You're the lead singer of a band called,
Who's got the key?
I do.
Well, can I have it?
You mean, may I have it?
May I have it?
No.
Nobody talk to me.
All right. So, you're the lead singer of a band called, Morningwood.
Yes! Yes.
Morningwood.
Okay, okay, get it out of your system already.
Hold on.
Are you aware that that name has a less than pure connotation?
Don't sass me, Space Ghost. I'll kill you.
You will not.
I'll hunt you down and kill you and then steal your job.
Oh, baby. You just lit my loins on fire.
Now you listen here, young lady.
I'm gonna slap Happy on your face when you sass me.
Hummina, 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 hummina.
I do the sassing around here, Missy. And when I do, people die.
I slap myself in the face and I pinch my nipples.
Let me see.
Yes.
Wait, I'll get my camera.
No, no.
Oh, playing hard to get, are you?
Come sit on my lap.
Yeah, baby. That's more like it.
Stop fraternizing with a guest.
Can somebody unzip my suit? It really smells bad in here.
I'm a fan of boys made out of wood.
Oh, once I got a splinter from smashing Space Ghost kneecap with a 2x4. Does that count?
That's hard. That's really tough.
Oh, come on. That should totally count.
You can come on the road with us.
Whoa, baby. Zorak ain't looking for no ball and chain. Just a little loving now and then.
Hey, I'm management. You'll direct your inquiries to me, thank you.
Please, 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 please.
I ain't no sugar daddy, toots.
I smell a wedding.
Yes! Yes!
Yeah!
Yes, yes, yes.
Oh, wait. Nah, that's just my helmet.
All righty, Miss Interspecies Romance 2006. I think we're about out of time, so take care and go easy on the pension.
Bye, Space Ghost. Come visit me and do my merch.
That sounded dirty. Was that dirty? Because I'm not into that.
You can actually rub lotion on it if you want.
Or that.
Greetings, netizens, and welcome back for another installment of this dog and pony show we lovingly call Space Ghost Coast to Coast.
Ooh. Anybody else get goosebumps?
You're such a putz.
Zorak, there's nothing you can say to bring me down from the natural high that, one, comes from me hearing the sound of my own voice, and two, being the recipient of the Intergalactic Association of Broadcasters Golden Throaty Award for Most Pleasing Voice. Late Night Talk Show, Basic Cable Category.
Would you just shut up about it already?
And deprive my audience of the mellifluous tones for which this award was so richly deserved?
Oh, no, no, no. I don't think so.
Seriously, I'm this close to snapping.
Snap away,
he'll,
bud.
He'll get to you in a minute. I swear. Anyway.
I ought to come over there and paste one on you, throaty boy. Yow.
So, I got a metal band myself. Yeah, we call ourselves the Magma Smashers, and, well, we rock wicked hard. And, well, I can send you a demo if you want.
You're kidding, right?
Now, where was I? Ah, yes, today we have a very special guest, D. Snider of that gender-bending smooth jazz quartet, Twisted Sister.
You are a putz.
It's sickening.
Both of you will speak only when spoken to. So saith the Golden Throat.
Zorak, Moltar, haven't you just had it with Space Ghost's arrogant attitude? He's so condescending, he talks down to you.
I don't know who you think you are, mister. You realize you're talking to the winner of a Golden Throaty Award? Moltar, where's D. Snider?
That is D. Snider.
I don't think so.
Yes, it is.
It's me, Space Ghost.
Me who?
If you're you, you would look like this. Everyone knows that.
It is D. Snider. You're just without the makeup, your little throne and the costume, the shoulder pads, the hair's here. I just, you know, unlike yourself, a man who always wears his costume, I only wear mine when I'm performing on stage.
Uh-huh. If I had a dollar for every time I've heard that flimsy story, I'd have, Moltar, how much would I have?
$63. Two more and I'll sell you my old iPod.
Huh, tempting. Not really. Listen, friend, if you are who you say you are, prove it. Sing something for Daddy.
I wanna rock!
I'm not convinced. But if you really are D. Snider, then welcome to the show.
Well, are you really Space Ghost?
Well, are you really D. Snider?
We have a problem, Space Ghost. I mean, I sense a little tension here. It looks like, is it go time?
Well, that would depend on where you want to go.
Do I got to come down there and we got to throw down, you and me? Hermano, hermano?
You think you could take me? I'm a superhero, D. I have a little something called superpowers. I'm not just about the fantastic award-winning voice. Well, mostly, I do have a great voice.
Oh, we're throwing down.
Yeah, throw down! Throw down! Kick him in the throat!
Where are you? Give me the address. I'm coming there. I'm coming to get you!
I don't think I care for the cut of your jib, mister.
I've seen you. I've watched you. You're an arrogant son of a bitch, Space Ghost.
Are you taking a tone with me? You're taking a tone.
He's taking a tone, isn't he? Is he taking a tone?
You're taking a tone. He's taking a tone with me.
A little bit, yeah.
I cannot believe the people that work with you, Moltar, Zoltak, whatever the name is.
Zorak, moron.
I can't believe they have not risen up against you, quite honestly. You're really full of yourself.
I'll have you know that my ego is completely justified by this lovely bronze statuette.
Just stand up to this guy. Tell him you've had enough.
Yeah, we've had enough.
You know, that all you can stand, you're not gonna take it anymore.
We're not gonna take it.
No.
No, we ain't gonna take it.
Get right in his face.
We're not gonna take it anymore.
You don't have to take it.
I will not tolerate an insurgency on this show.
You're just as good as he is. You should have your own show.
Wrong. Moltar, end the show.
No way, Ghost.
Dump the dude in the suit. Space Ghost coast to coast. No. Zorak and Moltar coast to coast.
Death to America, Space Ghost.
Bring it, Bug.
Is this it? Is this the final battle? Has the Reaper come for me at last? Is this the end of Space Ghost?
Okay, listen up, boys. We are in trouble. Our ratings are down. The network's breathing down my neck, and I don't like the way that feels. It's hot and wet and reeks of fish sticks. What we need is a stunt to boost viewership.
Oh, I know. We could show live cockfighting.
They already have that on TBS. It's very funny.
All right, it's on after Raymond. Hey, why don't we have Patricia Heaton on for a frank discussion of political morality? Huh? Huh? That'd be a ratings bonanza.
No, Zorak, I don't think so. We need to do something to get people talking. Moltar, bust out the baby oil. Greetings, citizens. Marvel at the sight of my well-oiled, glistening masculinity. This is for you, female viewers. Behold.
Ugh, I'm gonna barf in my helmet.
Oh, God. Hey, leave some room. I'm gonna barf in it, too.
And that's not all. For you male members of the audience who aren't turned on by that sort of thing, I have found a special sexy treat. Please welcome that sizzling, spicy, hot burlesque act, the Barenaked Ladies. Moltar, where are the naked ladies? What are you punks trying to pull? Why are you not women?
Why are you not a woman? Why are you not a ghost?
I am a ghost. Didn't you see me materialize?
Perhaps we're women.
Did you see me menstruate?
Anyone? No? Alrighty. Well, despite your claims to menstruation, you are clearly not chicks. So who are you? Explain yourselves.
We're in a rock band that is called Barenaked Ladies.
We're very popular.
Sometimes the names of rock bands aren't completely literal.
Uh-huh. So how often are you confused for a sizzling hot burlesque act?
Well, it's not usually about the name. It's usually when people bump into us on the street. They just assume, because of the way Steve and I look, that we are a racy burlesque act.
You ever use those tassels?
The tassels are good, but just for the size of nipples I have, they just never seem to fit properly.
So, what do you think of my nipple? Pretty impressive, no? You think tassels would work for me?
That's not a bad nipple, actually.
Too true. In fact, this nipple might be all that stands between me and television oblivion.
Hallelujah! Free at last, free at last!
Oh yeah, like you want to get canceled. What would you do without this show?
Well, if you must know, I'm in talks for a new sitcom starring me and Patricia Heaton for TBS. I play a lovable but harried father of three, married to a tart-tongued part-time judge. It's very funny.
I've got an option to produce.
Perhaps Oblivion is here and I just haven't realized it yet. Moltar, ratings check. Is my nipple bringing in viewers?
No.
No? I don't understand.
We're down 61% with female viewers.
My God, we're hemorrhaging our core audience. Only one course of action to take.
Whew, Women viewers now down 83%.
Impossible! How could any woman resist the hypnotic allure of my manly areola?
Women viewers now down 103%.
I don't get it. Guys, help me out. You're Canadian. Do something sensational. Or sensational.
Oh, I know. Fight.
Fight.
Hey, not my glasses.
Come on, girls, get a hold of yourselves. Remember, kids, violence is never the answer.
You pansy.
No, boys, if we're going to get people talking about this show, we need a real controversy. Zorak, tongue-kiss Moltar.
What? No way.
Yeah, I'm with him. Just not in that way.
Oh, well, you guys are a lot of help. Thank you very much. Oh, Lord, what would Patricia Heaton do? Ah!
Way to go, Chief.
Dear Space Ghost, due to poor ratings and a cease and desist letter from Patricia Heaton's lawyers demanding your immediate dismissal, you're canceled! Please let Zorak know that we're picking up his show and that Patty can't wait to get started.
Booyah! In your face, Ghost!
I can't believe it. What am I going to do?
Barenaked Ladies, as the ambassadors of Canada, will make sure that you stay right here.
Really? Could you get me on the CBC?
Absolutely.
Space Ghost is truly touched by the love that pours forth like maple syrup tapped from your stolid Canadian hearts. CBC, here I come.
That's the Canadian Bacon Channel.
I love back bacon. Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all thy sons command.
Learn to speak Canadian, Volume 1. Listen and repeat. What's this all about, eh?
What's this all about, eh?
Take off, hoser.
Take off, hoser.
Where is my toque?
Where is my toque?